Referee Yuji Shimada getting things underway in the Mall of Asia Arena in the beautiful Philippines. 11 fights coming up for you. And this is where we begin. Mario Satya Wirawan in the multicolored shorts. That's a bright pair of trunks, Mitch Shilson. And in the white shorts, Xie Bin of China.
Yeah, Wirawan likes to start quick. You know, he knows he's up against a good striker here in Xie Bin. Wirawan does own one of the fastest KOs in ONE history with 6 seconds. Nice little leg kick there from Wirawan.
Big right hand though from Xie Bin, inched his way in and sent that right hand through the guard, and it landed very nicely.
Both these fighters are pretty tall for the bantamweight division, so they got a nice long reach. So we should be expecting some nice punches being traded by these two.
He's got good hands, Xie Bin, isn't he? Just extended a nice little left hand for us. Wirawan just slipped as he delivered that kick. The Chinese fighter not quite quick enough to take advantage.
Xie Bin looks really comfortable and relaxed in there. He went to war with Casey Swear the other last time in Jakarta, and he learned a lot from that fight, and he's hoping to put it to good use here tonight in Manila.
That was a big step up for him to take on Casey Swear, and he did okay, you know, lost a split decision. You can't get much closer than that. Just took a really solid kick to the thigh, and it's immediately reddened, and his left leg collapsed underneath him. There was some strength, and he goes for it again, not surprisingly. Wirawan has found a potential weakness in his opponent's armor. Can he exploit it even more? If he does, he'll have to be careful of those quick hands that the Chinese fighter has already displayed.
Yeah, Wirawan's putting these combinations together quite well. He's attacking the body right there, using the body kicks, using the leg kicks, mixing things up nicely, giving Xie Bin something else to think about. Oh, looks like a knee might have connected as Xie Bin takes him to the ground.
He went for the double leg just as the knee came up, didn't he?
Looks like he might have grazed him on the top of the head there, Wirawan did. But, you know, Casey Swear, the one who fought Xie Bin back in Jakarta, is Wirawan's teammate. So I'm sure he got a lot of helpful information for the contest here tonight.
This fight is brought to you by Chun Long Yu Le, D88.com. Just about to reach the halfway mark in the opening round. This is a three-round contest.
Nice little transition to get a takedown of his own to let Wirawan get up on top. Xie Bin's trying to keep his posture nice and controlled so Wirawan isn't able to land any big strikes from the top position.
But there was one.
There's another one. Yeah, two big right hands from Wirawan, bringing those punches down onto the prostrate Wirawan, onto the prostrate Xie Bin's face. Now strike here, elbow. 2 minutes left of the opening round.
Xie Bin still trying to control that posture, keep Wirawan nice and close. He's opening up his guard, possibly threatening to set something up. He just throws some heels to the backside of Wirawan, though. Pushes away. Hops back up. Let's see these two trade again.
Ooh, good left jab, isn't it? Got really nice hands, the Chinese fighter.
He seems to have a slight edge in the stand-up here, except Wirawan was landing them kicks, and there's another one of them.
See how red that left thigh is, the outside of his thigh.
I can see him go right back to it because it's working quite well.
I always say those thighs will be very, very painful the next day, sort of glibly overlooking the fact that they're probably quite painful now.
You know, they definitely hurt. They can bother you, can slow your movement down. And especially as the fight progresses into the later rounds, those leg kicks, man, they just build up and add so much damage.
Actually, as he inches closer to us, you can see there's a welt on that thigh. It's not just redness, really swelling up. That's going to be very, very sore as this fight goes on. And he's very fast with those kicks. Just trying to send that one up to the head. Wirawan, who studied accounting and banking and finance at university. Played varsity soccer as well, so he's a real all-rounder. That's Xie Bin just trying to inch forward and take control of the cage in these closing moments of the opening round. Just 15 seconds left now. You'll hear that tap, which signals 10 seconds left in every round. Flying knee gets caught by Wirawan, and he tries to take advantage with a right hand, but he gets a couple of right hands of his own in the face, and that was a very engaging first round, Mitch.
Yeah, good opening round for both fighters. See here, there's that knee that just kind of grazed the side of Xue Bin's head as he ended up in the top position here. They were kind of reverse positions back and forth. Here's Wirawan landing some nice strikes from the top. Interesting fight to see how Rich Franklin's going to have that one score. Rich, what do you got for us?
Well, I'll tell you, this is a good fight to actually score, to see how the game plans are unfolding. Both these guys are even on takedowns. They each have a couple takedown apiece. The ground control is the big difference in this fight. Wirawan obviously controlled the ground, mounted some good ground and pound. In my striking superiority category, I would actually have Xie Bin ahead on that. However, the leg kick that Wirawan landed to Xie Bin shows that it had a little bit of damage because it actually took him off his feet. So I've scored Wirawan in that category. At this point in time, if the fight was stopped, Wirawan, in my opinion, would have the decision.
So many aspects to the judging of this fight, because the attacks are coming from all directions from both fighters. Very difficult for Rich and our three judges at the cage side to assess who's in the lead.
Make it, okay. Push them out.
Let's see if the game plan changes for either one of these fighters, but they seem to be playing into both their skill sets. Nice little straight right hand there from Wirawan. And a good jab again. Xue Bin's really throwing that jab. Nice.
The corners too.
Kick to the body there. Nice little straight teep kick from Xie Bin. Looking to vary his attack, and both of these guys have beautifully varied stand-up attacks. Very engaging contest to see. And this is the first fight of the night, folks. 11 fights on this card, and we're culminating in a double header, two world championships in our main and co-main event. Good right hand from Xie Bin.
We're starting to see some swelling, Steve, under the right eye of Wirawan. A bit more damage being displayed. Xue Bin's got that nice hook straight combo.
Stop.
Throws that real cleanly right down the middle.
Let's go. Hands first. You gotta connect.
You can see here Wirawan's corner screaming out hands first, meaning he wants him to put something together with that leg kick, not just throw these naked leg kicks out.
Right hand left kick, right hand left hook.
See, there's that jab, it comes off really fast. And that long, I think he's got a bit of a reach on him, so he's able to slide that right in there quite nice.
This is a fast-paced contest, Mitch, this one. That jab comes out quickly, as you say, but it's just beautifully straight. I mean, it's arrowed towards the chin.
Xue Bin's only 18 years old, Steve, so the sky's the limit for this kid. He's improving every single time. Nice double leg. Reaches in there, snatches and passes beautifully right over into side control.
Thought for a minute he was going to be subjected to a possible guillotine choke, but he moved so quickly around.
Wirawan's able to get one leg back in and actually able to recover guard. So good ground skills displayed by Wirawan.
Midpoint in the second round. Halfway through the contest, judges score these fights in their entirety, not round by round. So keep that in mind when we go to Rich Franklin to get his updates and his opinion as to how the judges will see this.
Ooh, that could have been a headbutt. I think that was possibly unintentional, but he's got to be careful with that.
Certainly hope it was unintentional. That's entirely illegal.
He's trying to put his head up under the chin of Wirawan just to be able to control the position and be able to throw that left hand a little bit better.
Referee Yuji Shimada, our most experienced one championship referee.
See Wirawan trying to get his feet onto the hips to maybe create some space and kick off. He's got to be a little bit more active. Oh, here comes the punches. See Wirawan trying to circle around, take that leg. Oh, he's locked in a darce. Oh, Wirawan's got to move out the other way. He's got to go the other way. He's locked in the thing. Now it's a tight to an anaconda. Oh, he's rolling the wrong way. Oh, Steve, it's deep. It's deep. Wirawan's tough, though. He's fighting it.
That left leg is trapped, though, between Dibin's two legs. Oh, he seems very unable to get any kind of... Oh, has he now? Has he now?
Oh, oh, he pops out. Wirawan gutting through the choke.
Great strength of character. A minute left in the second round.
Yes.
Good round for Xie Bin, man.
Finish.
He's really displayed a submission attempt, lots of ground and pound. That's pretty much where this fight is played out. You can see Wirawan just trying to clutch onto the double underhooks from guard and just really trying to hold him down to not take any more damage.
Let's go.
He's got to create some space. He's got to get some movement. He can't end the round like this.
Oh, good up kick from Wirawan. Gives himself a little bit of time to get back on his feet and bring this contest back to a stand-up situation. But with only 18 seconds left, how much of an impact can these two do? Well, a flying knee will create some impact for you.
Nice little flying knee there shown by Xie Bin. Really mixing up the attacks. Not much of a kicker, but he will come at you with a flying knee. I like that. Let's take a look at some of the past action from this round. There's a hook that landed nicely, followed up with a straight right that just barely missed. Here's a beautiful double leg takedown. He slides in and just jumps right past the guard to end up in side control. Here he is threatening with that kind of an anaconda type choke there, but he lost the leg and Wirawan was able to gut his way out and survive that round. Really good round for Xie Bin, and it just a really good display of overall.
Each bout here, 3 5-minute rounds. Our two championship bouts, there'll be 5 5-minute rounds. Kicks to the head of a grounded opponent are illegal. When the judges get to score these fights, they look at near KO or submission, damage, striking superiority, and ground control. They'll also look at takedown and takedown defense, plus aggression. We'll get to Rich Franklin at the end of this contest, if indeed we get to an end. That will be the scheduled 15 minutes and get his view on who's won this. These fighters have 5 more minutes to determine their own fate. 3 judges at cage side will have the final call.
Right now, it definitely looks like Xie Bin starting to surge ahead in this contest. He's starting to do a lot more damage to Wirawan. Wirawan's got to kind of kick this into the next gear if he wants to show something. Fights are not judged round by round, like you said earlier, Steve. They're judged in its entirety, so this is still anybody's chance.
Now, this would be a big win for Xie Bin. He's got a 1-2 record, and he's fighting a fighter with a winning record of 5-4, so that's... A good mark in your record, if you can get the W here. Not done yet, though.
Yeah, Steve, we've got a talent-stacked bantamweight division, and the king of the bantamweights is coming up later tonight, so you don't want to miss that one.
Bibiano Fernandez, multiple BJJ world champion and the most enduring ONE Championship title holder. Meanwhile, here, we're back on the deck.
Beautiful single to a double leg takedown, able to end up in the mounted position. And now he looks like he's taking the back of Wirawan. Wirawan's doing the right thing, fighting that choke off. Uh-oh, he lets Xie Bin get the hooks in.
Let's go, get a hand control, work out here.
Takes a few punches from behind to the front of the face.
He's got to be careful. He's got to fight those hands. Doesn't look like he's quite under the chin, but he's doing the right thing by fighting that top hand first. But Xie Bin changed his grips, and now he's got that rear naked choking. But he's in a bad position, but there gets the second hook. Looks like Xie Bin's trying to flatten him out, but Wirawan's doing a good job of struggling out of this.
I think he's
bad
looking
position.
For another. He's looking for another go at it, isn't he? And this in the third round, their bodies are slippery. So if you do get that neck crank, easier to slide the arm underneath the chin and get it around the neck.
But he's a bit high. He's a bit high on the posture. He's got to get his hips down a little bit lower. Now he's in a better position. He's locked in the body triangle.
Definitely going to give it another go, isn't he? But for the moment, Wirawan's chin is down.
Pulling off the hand. Good. Good job for Wirawan to reverse that position. Now he's in the top.
Submission defense is something the judges do look at. Mario, slipped out of that two or three times.
But the submission defense is not going to outweigh the submission attempt.
For sure.
Finish. But he is doing his good job. I don't fighting out of this stuff. But Xie Bin is just really showing a much more diverse skill set and really just imposing his will in this contest.
Action!
But good fight from both these athletes so far. We got 2 minutes, so the tide can still be turned, but...
And yet, as you said, good fight from these two so far. Yuji Shimada called for more action. That's Yuji for you.
Up kick landed.
Pass the guard, go to the right, pass to the right.
You hear the corner of Wirawan screaming out instructions, desperately trying to get their athlete into a better position. Rich, is it possible for Wirawan to get the victory here?
It's possible, but he'd have to do a lot of stuff. You know, since Wirawan got hit with that right hand at about the 7 minute mark of the fight that you commented on, from that time until he did the reversal there, you really didn't see anything from him. Xie Bin was landing a lot of punches on the feet, had a nice takedown, a lot of ground control there, attempted submissions and all that kind of stuff. So he's really, at this point in time, we have a little over a minute left. He'd probably have to finish the fight. The lead is just too big at this point.
Nice takedown, just as Rich Flanken says that. Wirawan slides in, secures a double leg of his own, but Xie Bin's trying to pop out the other side.
He's not letting go, Wirawan.
No, he's not. He's got a good grip on those hips, making sure to suck those hips back in, so he's doing all the right stuff too.
It effectively just nullifies the final few seconds, though, and that is not what Wirawan needs. He needs to change things around.
He's got 40 seconds. If he can slide over into, you know, he's got a kind of a bad, precarious position there with the arm being
the
straight.
Arm,
Bin's
yeah,
doing the right thing to stop the full transition of turning that corner.
Pulls it at his opponent in close, limiting the damage he can do in these final 20 seconds. And if we're correct here at cage side, that means that Xie Bin can effectively coast to victory in these final few moments. 10 seconds left.
Looks like it's going to go to another decision for Xie Bin. All of his fights go to decision, so he's racking up a lot of experience at this young age. Lots of cage time here at ONE Championship. Good fight for Xie Bin.
Very, very entertaining indeed. Great experience for these two. As you say, Mitch, Xie Bin, he thinks he's done it, and it seems that way to us here at cage side.
Here's that attempted rear naked choke. It was creating some scrambles, trying to move. Wirawan did a good job of fighting off a lot of these attempts, but he took some damage in the process. Xie Bin decided to try to get away from it, create a scramble of his own, but Wirawan just kind of smothered him and did it. I think, you know, Xie Bin did enough to take this fight. Overall, good effort by the man from China, Xie Bin.
Let's hear from Dominic Lau with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this fight in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Xie Bin.